If you would like to make a comment on the monarchy, here's an easy-to-fill feedback form, which we placed on a file called Surveillance. No locking on, just locking up. The trick, he said, is pretend kindness, living a life in waiting whilst building up the most powerful PR company in Europe. Its strategy, a royal face on one of the tabloids every day. The more you see us, the more you might accept. Locked into the weeks of your life. Shall we count them? No matter, it's just a rough figure. Any complaint will be taken seriously.
My aunt is in love with the British royal family. She knows the full bio of each of its members. She was driven to tears in watching the royal wedding broadcast on Latvian public television. Dear James, if you happen to have the newspaper cut out pictures of Prince William as a toddler, Prince William as a lieutenant, Prince William in Afghanistan, Prince William rescuing 900 kilograms of cocaine, or Prince William in Wales, she would be thrilled if you send them to her. If something terrible happens in our region again, she knows Prince William will come on his helicopter for her. She has a garden with solid ground, a perfect place for landing. Her suitcases are already packed.
There's a new Royal Mail stamp depicting how Robin Hood robs the rich. The image of the stamp is this. The king pouts sculpturally, filthy in his whiteness, a head mask floating in the sky above Hood's henchmen. Hood has his sword drawn to the back of a flailing armed cardinal and his grey-robed financier, who has seen hollowed through the hollowed patina, smirking, Hood's own sword tapping the money pot, his left hand balled into a fist. And we know what they're trying to sell us, but it's spelt out nevertheless. Robin Hood robs the rich, first class, propaganda stamped, meaning how they value the rest of us. I wish your aunt a fresh umbrella as she waits for William. Once I was invited to Buckingham Palace, it was called the Commonwealth of Poets. The crown seal invitation on my doorstep made me think it was a letter from the taxman. I declined. The stooping poets at the palace were hemorrhoidally unsure, half bowing, and they were sold back the photo for £16 with a special offer to buy more, because the grandchildren must see them ridiculous. The following weeks, the Daleks were invited. It was the winter the Queen applied for a state poverty fund. Anyone on the brink might apply. Her application was to heat Buckingham Palace. It was the winter energy bills spiked and the elderly froze. The helicopter didn't arrive.
A man in a gay sauna in Riga tried to pick me up, talking about his two favorite subjects, health issues and the British royal family. Stroking my thigh, he said how much he was looking forward to the coronation. Pawing my cheek, he informed me about different ways to improve my skin and weight. Trying to tear off my towel, he commented on Camilla's character. We were four men in that grim sauna, the only gay sauna in Riga. One of them, the hot bath attendant, another had fallen asleep, the talkative man, and me. Not too much choice. Tiny scene, you take what you can, you stick to what you have. But sometimes you just want somebody to take you somewhere else, where golden unicorns dance on the gates decorated with wrought iron that open to let in the carriage.
A gate made of gold from the Gore. It used to be the king's procession right outside this gallery. Monarchy as hot seat of empire, slavery as landlords. They know this street well. In the real Gore, off the coast of Senegal, ships couldn't land to pick up more slaves because the dock was already too full with corpses. There are no reparations for this. Who is the unicorn and who is the pack horse? Monarchy, the spider in our ears at night. To have been taken elsewhere, like your man asleep in the bath, with the privilege of waking up, putting on white robes, and walking home. Thank you.
Ha ha ha.